Anyway, just getting things set up over here. Hopefully we'll have some people join us. Can you see my reindeer antlers? Oh good, some people are joining us. And I am going to put a little link in the comments. Let's see, I think most people who will join us are people who are planning to be here, but I know as you're scrolling through your feeds, it might be something that you're just being like, oh, I know Lauren, what's she doing? So today, I thought I would teach a live lesson. Hey Susan, hey Rudolph. Oh, that's right, we did Rudolph last year as a song. The sun is really at a good angle right here. But last year, it's kind of a yearly tradition that I go through a holiday song and teach people how to play it on their fiddle and on their fiddles. And so this year I'm doing that again. And this is like a song that's a little out of my comfort zone because it's rock. And I'm definitely, you know, like I love rock and roll. I would not say that I'm a hardcore rock and roller. Definitely more in the, you know, Americana old time bluegrass fiddle categories is where I'm more comfortable. But I love this song. I love Christmas songs. I love winter songs. I love really, really old Christmas songs or really old winter songs, but I also love new ones. Like I love Mariah Carey, and this is older than Mariah, for Queen. What is it, like maybe in the late 70s that this was written? Hey there, Eddie! And so what really excites me about this tune is that it's like such a ballad, even though it's rockin', and there are a lot of great chords. And if you know me at all, you know that I get really excited about chords. And so I thought we would work through this today. And the other thing that I discovered while working on this and charting it out is that it's crooked. And as an old-time fiddle player, I really like crooked tunes. And so maybe I should just explain what crooked is. I'm holding my hand in front of the sun, but I don't know if it's doing much, so I'm just gonna let half of my face look like a ghost. Okay, so a crooked tune or a song is when the phrase lengths are not all equal. Sometimes it could be a different length of beats in a bar as well. Like all measures don't have to have the same amount of beats, and that could stand for something being crooked. But in this particular case, it's because the verses and what I'm calling the bridge, all have four bars, for the phrases that each have four bars, but the chorus, or what I'm calling the chorus, is three bar lengths. I've heard some people call, the form, I'm calling it verses, chorus, there's one bridge. Some people call it like a verse, a pre-chorus, and then a chorus. But since this thing, the part that happens over and over again, seems more like a chorus, I'm calling it that. So, all right. Let me just make sure a couple things are right here. Yep, everything's looking good. And need to pull up my audio, make sure that the sound is still on here. Good. Okay, so hopefully you've had a chance to download the pages that Heather and I made up for you. This is a freebie download. I had it printed double-sided. You can do that. I realized that if you have it double-sided, then you can't you don't necessarily see how to play the chords, so you might like having that on two different pages, which is what I ultimately decided to do. But one page is the lyrics and the chord chart. Here's the chord chart. And then the other page is kind of like a fiddle tab. And I know a lot of people who are going to watch this will recognize these kind of charts of mine from books. But if you're watching this for the first time, this is kind of just like little teeny excerpts of how to play these chords that are in this Queen song. Okay, so the first thing that I think would be helpful for learning this particular song is to go over the form of it and follow along with the chord progression while the song is going, just so you understand if you're new to following a chord chart. I know a lot of people are not new to following a chord chart, but I just want to explain what's going on here. So we have verses 1, 2, and 3. So we play these 12 bars, okay? And then we go to the chorus, and then we go back to verse 2, and then we hit chorus 2. And then after chorus 2, it goes right to the bridge. And then the bridge goes to verse 3, and then we have chorus 3. So that's the form. Verse 1, chorus 1, verse 2, chorus 2, bridge, verse 3, chorus 3. And if you're following along with the words, it's just all the way down, but the words are listed this way. This song is in 12/8 time. And if you are familiar with any kind of jigs, this will feel almost like a jig. It's just that a whole bar gets 4 beats as opposed to 2 beats. So, oopsie, that went back. Sorry, I turned the volume up. So 12/8 is 4 beats that are subdivided into 3 equal pieces. So it would be something like, let me make sure my button isn't gonna buzz here. It'd be something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2 groups of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. My hand, you can see, you can either get my antlers or you get my hand, so gotta move it down, but that's the idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So if you're new to chopping, I think that learning how to chop in 6/8 is really great. It was one of the ways that I was successful to learn how to chop. This is not a chopping workshop, but the idea of it is that you're going up, up, chop, up, up, chop. And then after the chop, you hear those little subdivisions. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have to make sure you can't see it, but I'm almost hitting my antlers. These antlers might not be worth it. I can put them back on later. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you don't have to count to 12 if you don't want to. You could count 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And how I just counted is essentially the 4 beats of each measure in this chart. So we have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Okay, so hopefully that gives you an idea of how to read through the chart. So let's dive in and work on how to play some of these chords. And then we can maybe put the track on after we've practiced playing through some of them. And we can either try some chopping or some droning or some like bump, 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 bouncing kind of compound time stuff. Okay, so if you're new to chords, you know that you can play just the name of the chord. So like if it says a G chord, you can play just a G if you would like. Or if you're feeling like you can move beyond that, if you look at the second sheet of the handout, you'll see I provided two ways to play the G chord. And so these are little maps. All of these chords today are gonna be on the G and the D strings. And so right here, you could play the open G and the open D together, and that will be a G chord. Or you could play the B on your G string with that open D, and that could also be a G chord. There are so many ways to play a G chord on your fiddle, and if you wanna learn lots of different ways how to play those chords, I have lots of ways to teach you how to do that, and one of them is just like getting some of the chord books that I have, and these are pictures of examples of those books. But I also wanted to show you how, like, if you don't know how to use the book, this is a great way. You find a chord chart and you're like, what do I do, I need to find how to play a G chord, then you could use something like this. Okay, so let's go ahead and play the open G and D, and then we'll play the B, your middle finger on the G string, with your open D, and both of those could be how we play the G chord today. I put them both in there because I like to use both of them in this particular song. So that's the open G and D. My poor fiddle has a buzz. It's time for me to see my luthier. So that's G and D, and then if you put your B on the G string with that open D, that's the B and the D. Ways to play the G chord right there. Okay, so, and then if you go back to your chord chart, you know that the next chord we need to play is a C chord, right? It's a C chord. So if you look on your chord maps, down here are the C chords. And sorry, the sunlight is kind of glaring there. We can play on the G string, the open G, with the first finger E on the D string, or that same first finger E with a C on the G string. So those are two different ways to play a C chord. So let's play the open G with your first finger on the E string, first finger on the D string. That's the E and the G together making a C chord. Or if you keep that same E and you add your ring finger to the G string, there you go, you've got a C. So we've got two different ways to play the G chord, and we have two different ways to play the C chord. And you might notice from the chord chart that there are a ton of G to C movements. That's because it's the one and the four chord. And so in this particular song, so we've got the G. So if we count into four, one, two, three, four, that's four beats of G. But if you look at the chord chart, you might notice that on the fourth beat, there's a C chord, and it's just for one beat. So we need to quickly move to that C chord. And so the easiest way to do that is just by dropping our first finger on the D string and adding the E. So we could go one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Because that's what happens in the first two measures of the song. And the melody is, oh, two, three, my love, two, three, four. And so it's kind of fun that on the fourth beat of the measure, the four chord comes in. That was G and C. So let's try those two measures. Ready, set, G to C. G, two, three, C. G, two, three, C. Good, so notice I'm not playing a C, but it's nice and fast. Let's try it the other way. Let's try the other two voicings. So you've got the B, your middle finger on the D string, on the G string, with the open D. And then let's move to the C chord with your ring finger and your pointer. So we've got one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. So both of those are really nice. They sound really great. And you could do it differently every time because remember we have three different verses. So whatever's feeling better for you, is what you should do physically. Okay, or like if one of them's too much, then that's okay. That's something for you to work on later. Just grab what you need. You could just go G, two, three, C, G, two, three, C, that kind of thing. Okay, So notice in the third measure, we go back and forth between G and C again, just on every beat. Okay, so we'll work on that in just a sec. And then the last bar of that measure is A minor. And so if you go to your chord voicings page, you'll find an A minor chord, and you can use, look at the same E that we've been using, but this time your first finger is gonna be on both sets of strings. So it'll be the A and the E together. And that is an A minor chord. So let's practice that. We've got the first finger on both strings. The A and the E. Okay, so we're gonna practice going from G to C twice, and then the A minor, which would sound like this. So let's try that together, okay? We'll play the open G and D. Drop your first finger for the C chord. G and D. Drop your first finger. And then first finger on both strings. Yeah, okay. Let's try that. Ready, set, here we go. Two, three, four. Nice, okay. Let's back up and we'll do the first two measures. One. 2, G to C, G, 2, 3, C, G, 2, 3, C, here we go, G, C, A minor, 2, 3, 4, nice, okay, so you could practice that with the other voicings too. Can't mix them up within a measure or within a line. So we could go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And that's fun to do as well. Okay, the second line is very, very similar. It's only got one chord different. Okay, so you'll see in the third measure that there's an E minor chord. And if you look at your chord maps page, we've got E minor, and you can play that with the E that we've been using. It's a popular note. And then the B, your middle finger, on the G string. So, okay, so that's the only chord that's different. Let's practice going from the G to the E minor, and now to the A minor. That's what we'll need to do in quick succession. So let's do G, E minor, A minor. Go! Do it again. G, E minor, A minor. Yeah. Alrighty. So we have one new chord to learn, and then we're done with learning all the verses. Okay, so the D chord is the only chord that we haven't learned that's used in the verse. Okay, so the D chord, the 5 chord, is up. Sorry, I'm teaching this backwards. Okay, here's the D chord. Okay, so you've got the first finger A on the G string and the open D. Okay, so remember, you can download these charts. Okay, that's the D chord. So if you look at the third line, we have a back and forth between the G and the D, okay? We've got 4 bars of G. 1, 2, 3, 4, D, 2, 3, G, back and forth. And then the C, 2, 3, 4. That's what's going on. Okay, so let's practice that last line. Ready, set, here's G, go. G, 2, 3, 4, D, 2, 3, 4. Alrighty, let's do an entire verse. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. again later, but that was the verse. That was an entire verse, and that's gonna be the same for all verses 1, 2, and 3. So the great thing is that the chorus happens over and over again, but we just add to it a little bit, okay? But now it's Christmas. Yes, it's Christmas. Thank God it's Christmas. Where we have lots of what we call a borrowed chord in there. It's our first borrowed chord. So the chorus starts on A minor, which we've already learned is the A and the E together. And then in the second bar, it goes to C. And then the melody has this walk down. Thank God it's Christmas. That chromatic walk down. And so the chords are mimicking that. The melody's mimicking the chords, who knows what came first. But we're going to use a C, a C7, a C6, and then a C. And then we go to the borrowed E flat major chord, because E flat normally is not in the key of G. It's what we call a flat six, and it's super spicy and I love it. So for the C chord, we already know the C chord, the C. So let's use, for this particular purpose, we're gonna play the C and the E. Okay, so if we've got a two beats of C, and then we play the same E. The E is gonna happen for the entire time, but instead of playing the C, we'll play a B flat. That's for the C7 chord. And then we'll play an A with the E. This is for the C6 chord. And then we peel the first finger off of the G string, but we keep playing the E. So we'll play the E and the G together. And that's the walk down for the thing that is, the thing. The C, the goddess. Okay, so here's the C, C7, C6, C, and then the E flat uses the same G, but you're gonna move your first finger from an E to an E flat. So all of that together. What I love about that is that there's the next chord is always sharing one of the tones that you're already using. So it's kind of spidery where how your fingers are moving. Okay, so we've got the C and the E, B flat, A, G, and then move back to E flat. Yeah, okay. That's gonna happen in every single chorus. Depending on what chorus we're on will determine whether or not we add more. Okay, so that's the length of the first chorus. We've got the A minor, 2, 3, 4 to C, and here we go. A flat, 2, 3, 4. And so that's the, but now it's Christmas. Yeah, it's Christmas. Chopping pattern would be better if we go. And then you'll notice at the end of chorus two, we've got a G. And then after the C, it goes right into the bridge, which we need to learn an E chord for. We've learned E minor, and we've learned E flat, but we have not learned E major yet. Okay, so at the bottom of the page, the chord chart, we have E major, okay? And we could play an E and a B exactly how we learned how to play the E minor chord, or we could play the same E that we know and love and slide down to the G sharp. So we'd actually play this G sharp with your first finger and the E with your second finger in half position. I can show you that. But I just want to show the difference. See, even though we're playing a B and an E in both the E major and the E minor chord, you'll notice that the middle note is either a G sharp or a G. And they're similarly color-coded, but one's darker than the other. So the G sharp is what makes an E major chord, and the G is what makes an E minor chord. And hopefully that will help you visualize what's similar and what's different about those two. Okay, so let's see, if we are on a C chord, which you could have been playing the C and the E, like I just did, or you'd be playing the E and the G, and then we go to E major, you're gonna play the same E, but if you slide down from your first finger to your second finger, so listen, this is the C chord, and then there's the E major chord, which sounds great, and then, thank God it's Christmas. So that's what's happening. So the E major chord goes to the A major chord, and we're gonna actually play the A major chord exactly the same way that we were playing the A minor chord. So I'm making a point of telling you that it's A major instead of A minor because you'll hear that it sounds different, but you can play it the same way because they both have an A and an E. A major has the C sharp, A minor has the C. So similar to the differences between E major and E minor, right? It's the shell of the chord are the same, but what's happening in the middle makes it major or minor, okay? So we can go back and forth between this half position E chord, the G sharp, and the E, and slide up to A and E. So one and two to one and one. They both have the E in the chord. So listening to this note, so even though your hand is moving, making sure that's the same note. So, thank God it's Christmas. Thank God it's Christmas. Can it be Christmas? That's what this lyric is, sorry. I'm not a lyricist. Okay, so the bottom line of the bridge is going back and forth between C and D, and we've learned those chords previously. We just didn't go back and forth between them. We go back and forth three times, and then the A. Okay, so let's do the entire bridge. Here's the E chord. Okay, one, two, three, here's E. Thank God it's Christmas. Back to E. Thank God it's Christmas. This is the A. To C and D. Back to C and D. One more time. C and D. This is verse three. Second line. chorus three, at the end of the second line, it goes G and then C, D at the end of it, which lands us on to G, which is the third line of the last chorus. Okay, so we have the G for two beats and then C, D, four, five, one. Or you could go four, five, one is what I should have sung there. The melody went da-dum, boom. Okay, and then basically the song is done. It's not done, it's just riffing between the G and the C chords, the four and the five over and over again. But there's some fun bass lines that's kind of syncopated, dum, bum, 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 walking up to the C chord. And so that's what's been written in the bottom of the chart there. So after we have G. So let's go over that, okay? Because that happens quite a few times. Okay, so we've got the G for two beats, and then we're gonna walk from G, A minor, and then this is G over B. And what that means is that it's still a G chord, they just want the B to be the lowest sound of the chord. And so remember when I said, I'm gonna give you two voicings of that G chord, and I said, look at this is the B in the bottom. Sorry, I've got not enough hands right now. The B is the lowest sound in this voicing, because that's the note that's on the G string for us fiddlers. So having a B in the bass line is what's crucial, because we're hearing that G, A, B, which walks us to C. If we didn't put the G, if we had the G in the bass line for the G chord as opposed to the B, it would sound like this. Which is harmonically correct. So if you did that, it's not the end of the world. It's just that it's not quite as powerful as that moving bass line walking up to that C chord, okay? So we've got G, A, and then B in the bass line, and then C. Let's do it again. Here we go. Last time. And then we just kind of go between G and C. Because it's in the key of G. Hooray! We went through all of the parts. So what I'm thinking we should do is I'm going to put the Queen track on, and we will play through it, okay? And I'll like call out chords and the verses and stuff like that, but just try to hold on. And that's kind of the point of a lesson like this. It's like, okay, I love this Christmas song or this whatever song, and I'm not quite sure how to put my fiddle to it, because there's no fiddle in this tune. What could I possibly do? And this is a way for you to, you know, just have an opportunity to play along with one of your favorite recordings, or maybe if you want to learn how to sing and play at the same time, that would be pretty great. This is a lot of lyrics for me to teach and remember at the same time, so I didn't do a very good job of singing it and playing it, but maybe you have a family member or a friend who wants to sing it and you play, or you have a band and you, or a jam group and you say, hey, I have this chord chart and let's play it. You can start to do that. Okay, let's see here. I'm gonna get the sound back on my computer. And, okay, this track starts off right away from the beginning. So if you're gonna play along, let's get ready for that G. Remember, you don't have to chop. You can just like hold your bow out, G. So like G, two, three, C, G. Sorry about the announcements there, the alerts. Okay, all right, we got this, guys. Let's do this together. Thank God it's Christmas. G, two, here's the C. This is the second line. course, one A minor. Here's the fun part. Through the screen. And that's kind of the idea. I'm going to keep this live and hopefully I'll be able to get it posted onto my YouTube channel. So if you would like to keep practicing and playing along, obviously you have the charts. You can do that whenever you'd like and practice along with this, practice along with a Queen recording. Here, I think it's time for me to put these back on, don't you? But I wanted to say thank you for joining me on your Thursday afternoon. And, oh good, I'm glad that you had fun. Thank you. I had fun. You can see my Charlie Brown tree. It's a little bit more than a Christmas branch, but it's from our backyard. And I've got some ho 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 decorations up, as my daughter likes to call them, my 2-year-old. So hopefully playing around with, some songs will, some Christmas songs will help get you into the spirit if you're not already there. And yeah, this is kind of like my my fun end of the year tradition for me, is to learn a new to me Christmas song that I wouldn't have actually played before, just like sung along. And so this was a really fun one for me to learn, and I'm thankful that you guys are working on it with me. Oh, Nancy, you're so welcome. I'm really glad that you enjoyed it. Yay. So I'll get it posted, and if you're on my mailing list, you'll get some lists as you'll get an email later on with the links and everything like that for you. But feel free to share it with friends so you have somebody else to play this song with, okay? Because that's the whole point of making music. I want you to be able to share this with your friends and play more music. So have a nice end of your week. I hope you have some calm and some bright and some merriment in your week and to close out the rest of your year. Okay, thanks so much.